Here it is, friends. Ba-boom! The toy that we've been waiting 29 years for. Seriously, I wanted one of these so bad when I was in second grade. That's when Sonic 2 came out. And aside from aging me a bit, that also tells you just how long I've loved this franchise and how long I've been waiting for some really cool action figures like this. And oh, I cannot wait to get this thing open. This is so exciting. This is the Death Egg Robot from Sonic 2. The Death Egg Robot, of course, also appeared in Sonic Generations and Sonic Mania, and of course there was alternate versions of the Death Egg Robot in Sonic and Knuckles. So this is a mech suit that has been part of the franchise for a long time, and it is super cool, and I just cannot wait to get this thing open. Toast. So first off, this set comes with a very large blue piece of cardboard. Same design that's been coming with a lot of the classic or 30th anniversary figures from Jak Specific lately. So this is cool. I'm going to keep this one for sure. So the first thing we're going to look at is the catapult that it comes with, along with a mini Sonic figure rolled up in a ball. And it launches him. I'm like afraid to launch it hard. Let's see how far it goes. He's not even coming out. Oh, there he goes. He just came out. Let's see. Oh, there we go. So this Sonic figure is actually kind of rubbery, and he might look familiar to you. As you may recall, Jak Specific did their set of Sonic Mania figures that were in balls, like Super Monkey Balls. And the Sonic one that came with the Green Hill Zone playset looked just like this. Or did he? So here is the catapulting Sonic that comes in this set, and here is the old one that came in the ball. As you can see, they do look very different despite being in the same position. And if you look at them from the side, you can see they are completely different figures. So kudos to Jak Specific for not just recycling the same old Sonic figure that they had already made. Another thing is that this new one is very feels like rubbery. It feels like a pencil eraser, whereas this one, though it still it does feel, it's harder plastic. Not super hard, but it is there. And there you go. So they are completely different figures. Honestly, from the ads and everything, I totally thought that they were just recycling this Sonic figure and having it come with this set. But nope, it is a brand new sculpt, brand new figure, and it looks better, which is cool. And to think back in the day, when these came out, I thought this was going to be Jak's version of the 2.5-inch. Like, they have the 2.5-inch Mario figures. I thought these were going to be the Sonic equivalent. Oh, how wrong I was. And oh, how happy I am that we have the really cool 2.5-inch line today that Jak makes. Ba-boom. Here he is in all of his glory. For size comparison, here he is next to the 4-inch Sonic and the 2.5-inch modern Sonic figures. And in comparison to the classics, here's the 4-inch classic Sonic and the 2.5-inch classic Sonic. So that is how he sizes up. He is pretty massive and pretty impressive, and that is pretty cool. So let's start by looking at his articulation. So we have a turning head. Very cool. Of course, his arms go up and down. And, well, they come off quite easily. Matter of fact, when I opened the box, he fell apart, like, immediately. Oh, there's some rubber bands on here still. What do those do? Well, the shoulder pads can move. And looks like he does have a ball joint on here. Is it a ball joint, or is it just a hinge kind of thing? Yeah, oh, but it does have an R on it, so you know that is the right arm. It clicks right in. Pretty loosey-goosey on the arms. Can't really have them stand up very well, but he does have bending elbows here. And then these big gray buttons make him fire his arms, and then his arm pops right off. Boy, his arms pop off easily. And so that is the arms. Whoops, there it goes again. The jetpack, of course, has these little flames that come out. Too bad there's no bombs that pop out. If you ever go behind him in Sonic 2, he shoots these little bombs out his back. So those would have been great accessories. The backpack does come off, just like the arm that just popped off. And then we have the legs, which articulate like so. And they can go up this much. He has bending knees. You can hear them clicking to an extent. So he's got some pretty decent articulation, I guess, for the size of the figure. I kind of wish we could straighten his feet more, but oh well. Oh well. And then, of course, he has the hit point right in the chest where, well, when you hit it, it changes. And it is pretty sensitive, so that when you hit him with Sonic, it will change. You know, it will react. So if we put the arms back on, let's take him for a test as we get our catapult. We got our Sonic, and let's let him have it. Come on. Sonic likes to stay in there. French. Bears. Butt. Cranberries. Ah, I totally hit him that time. There we go, got him. And it changed. Let's do it one more time. Let's go. Hey. Dang it. Here we go. Okay, get him this time. I can sense it in my feet. Here we go. Oh, I totally hit him. Totally hit him. You saw that. Come on. Jeez. Crackers. What the bears? Here we go. Nope. All right. French toast. Here we go. Ugh, bears. Hey, I've got a better idea. Knock, knock. It's Idris Elba. Ha. So, even though I'm not crazy about how easily the limbs fall off and how the arms can't stay up, still, I think this thing is totally worth it. He looks fantastic, and I feel like he's just made to be the centerpiece of every Sonic figure collection. Whether you're using, you know, the 4-inch figures or the 2.5-inch figures, or even, you know, your Jazzwares or Tomy figures or Resource, whatever, this thing is just so cool looking. This is meant to be the center of the attention. This is so awesome. I just love it. Just love it, love it, love it. And so, you know what? This thing deserves to be on the shelf. So, as many of you know, I have a cubby dedicated to each of my favorite characters, and this one was originally meant to be a Dr. Robotnik shelf, but my first four figures, Dr. Robotnik, did not fit in the cubby, so it became sort of Robotnik and Metal Sonic, and eventually just tied in all of his other robots they had figures of. So this is his cubby, and I think it's time to do a little rearranging. Alright, so I decided to rearrange this cubby to make it exclusively just Dr. Robotnik and Metal Sonic figures and stuff like that. So, as I was getting ready to put him in my Dr. Robotnik Eggman Empire cubby, I decided to set up a photo of all the different Eggman robots they got figures of, along with the man himself right there. And I decided to take a picture for Instagram, and just thought, since I haven't finished this video yet, I'll go ahead and show it in this video. So there we go, just a nice little setup that I wanted to put together for fun of all the ones that they've made figures of that I've been able to collect over the years. And don't forget, way up in the back, there's Boko and Deco way back there. Hey guys! So friends, let me know in the comments section if you're picking up this figure or if you already have. And which others of Robotnik's inventions do you want to see Jack Specific make figures of? Have a fantastic day and toast!